Swick, Chris Lieben, a great wrestler. I mean, you work with Randy Couture, Matt Littlett, all those guys from Team Quest. You know you bring the goods. Mike Swick, a great stand-up fighter, worked hard on his ground game, very well-rounded. A lot of people think the winner of this will be fighting in one of the elite organizations coming up after this fight.
So Lieben is pressing the action to try to probably get Swick down to the ground. Nice toe stomp.
Yeah,
by
how
Lieben.
About that? A little foot stomp. Marco Huas made that legendary. And right now, Lieben, this is where he wanted. He wanted to close the distance immediately. He does not want to stand up with Mike Swick. He's seen the tape. He knows how dangerous Swick is with those kicks, with those knees. Another foot stomp. Is he those again? Tell you what, effective by Lieben. Any means necessary. Swick right now is pretty effective in his clinch, too. Tell you what, he can fire knees, but right now he's getting his feet stumped on.
Well, you just think of the people out of there. Crazy Bob Cook, one of the best leg lock specialists, leg submission specialists ever. And then you got Frank Shamrock from the AKA. On the other side, Team Quest has got Lindland, Couture, Henderson. I mean, these are some of the great all-time names in MMA.
No doubt about it. You just spend time with those guys. I mean, that makes your game better in a hurry. Tell you what, Lieben's been landing those footsteps. And you see Swick, he wants to land those knees. That's his game. He loves to be in the clinch, loves to land the knees. He would love to you know, get apart from Lieben right now. Lieben doing a nice job of just fighting in the clinch. He wants some footsteps, some lefts to the body. Josh Rosenthal watching closely. The guys slow down a little bit. He'll break him up. Lieben just wants, this is what he wants. He wants to close the distance and land some shots and try to score some points. Can he pick up Swick?
Yeah, a little bit too long, didn't have the leverage. He needs to circle to his left and change elevations in order to get his hips under him to go ahead and execute the lift. But I think the right foot of Swick is starting to be affected
I tell you right.
by some of those foot stops.
You're starting to see a nice red area there on top of the foot of the left foot of Mike Swick. Looked like right there, Lieben wanted to throw it, couldn't do so.
One thing's for sure, when you're the aggressor here and your opponent's up against the fence, you're the one spending more energy. And Lieben is spending a lot of energy here driving Swick into the fence. The fence is holding Swick up.
Right there, how about Swick changing position there? But now he's going to do some foot stops. How do you like that? Turn about fair play. Mike Swick. Man, some foot stops now on Chris Lieben. Oh, that did it. Wow. That was quick.
But is it me, or do I see a little color on the toes of Lieben?
Toe paints.
It must be green for go. That's all I can think.
So now Lieben trying to turn his way away from the kicks. You see that? He's trying to push off, get his shoulders away so he's not trapped.
That's exactly it. You know, Swick, the top man, always wants to push the bottom man's head towards the cage. It limits mobility. And that makes you a stationary target, easier to work out.
Right now, Lieben working in the guard. Swick taking his time. He wants to get his arms
close
to try and throw some bombs.
It's also a five-round fight. You got to pace yourself.
There we go. This is what I thought. Swick could just stand up and scoot back. He wants to let him up. He wants to land his shots. He wants to land those kicks. He wants to use the reach to his advantage. Oh, this with a high.
Left hand.
Mike Swick is hurt.
This might do it right now.
Mike Swick is in big trouble. He got hit. He was out for a half second. And now, right now, Lieben trying to sink in a choke. You can see, though.
Slowly getting it. Left hand.
Wow. Chris Lieben surprises him with that foot.
He'll strike to try to get Swick to move his hands. He'll go back to the choke.
It's hard to see from our vantage point. It does not look like it's under the chin.
Not yet.
Wow. Lieben. Oh, that was close. Look at that. Look at that. Uh-oh. Swick, you can see it. Swick trying to tuck his chin. Now he's trying to get out. Oh, boy. I tell you what, Swick is doing all he can to try to get out of this choke.
And with the figure four, Lieben is not going to leave his back. With that figure four, Lieben is glued to his back.
40 seconds. Can Mike Swick hold on for 30 more seconds? Unbelievable.
I'll tell you, the figure four on the midsection alone is going to cut the air of Mike Swick.
Wow. Chris Lieben, so quick. Just when Swick wanted him in his world of standing up, He takes a shot. And now he's just trying to hold on and hang out through this first round. That's Swick. Oh, and then, Mike Swick. He survives that first round. Boy, Swick was dropped. You can see he didn't know where his corner was.
Swick really didn't know where his corner was. He looked to the left, see him, and kind of came around.
You see his trainer, Bob Cook, right now, going to try to revive him.
Hey,
pour some water on him. Let's show this shot here by Chris Leben.
It'll be a left hand right there.
Oh, right on the chin.
It was kind of a left hook, caught him square on the chin and dropped him.
And it was almost the end of the fight.
Yeah, you got another look. You got to give Swick credit for coming back from that onslaught with the rear naked choke. Right there, he is stunned. And Leben, to his credit, started throwing the punches, but as soon as he got a chance to take the back, in came the rear naked choke, but he couldn't put Swick away.
There's Bob Cook in the red, trying to wake up Mike Swick, say, hey, man, let's go. This is a five-round fight.
Let's go.
Let's get it going in the second round here.
Well, obviously, round one to Leben.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Chris Leben.
Let's fight.
Here's the other interesting part about this.
The mouse under Swick's right eye.
Oh, yeah. You see that start to swell. That will play a part. Now, Swick. Oh, now he lands a left-right combination. Oh, Leben knocks him with a left hand.
Another left hand.
Josh Rosenthal's calling the fight.
Good call. Swick is not there. That's a good call.
Here's the, I was just going to say, Jeff. Chris Leben is a southpaw. And it's hard when you train with righties to deal with a southpaw, but Chris Leben, I tell you what, just landed another left hand.
Swick's world. They're trading, and Swick's hitting him.
Yeah.
Swick is hitting him, and Leben's still coming forward, but that left.
Forget about it. Knocked him out. I mean, these guys were just throwing. I mean, Swick, it looked like he was going to get the advantage, and then he just ate that left hand.
Wow.
I think Swick felt as though he won those exchanges and felt that he could move forward to hit.